But where is this from? It's from Kentucky.
It's Kentucky.
Why is Kentucky? What's so good about Kentucky?
Phil, do not be racist, okay?
This place called Cuba, and with my brother, he's a whiskey enthusiast, and he says this is, I think, the biggest collection of whiskey in Taiwan. What are you here to have a taste?
Yeah, he was saying it's something like, well, he thinks $10 to $20 million worth of whiskey.
$10 to $20 million?
Yeah,
in
U.S.
In this room, right?
Yeah, that's what he was saying.
I turned 40 about a week ago.
That's cool.
And my brother wants to get that for me.
Birthday present?
Yeah.
That are 10, 20 grand here. But they don't, oh, look at this. You know how many bottles? This is like 3, 4 grand minimum. Some of these, this one I think is like, I don't know.
Italian. So they have a, I guess they have a series on photography.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
I know.
California has this many bottles of Pappy's.
What's so good about this?
This is the most exclusive. A bottle of this goes for 1-2 grand each, man.
But where is this from? It's from Kentucky.
It's Kentucky.
Why is Kentucky? What's so good about Kentucky?
Phil, do not be racist, okay? It's like the...
Usually, good whiskey comes from...
No, this bourbon
Scotland.
Is different.
Oh,
no,
bourbon.
Not this bourbon. This is...
favorite movies?
The first one?
Just the whole trilogy.
The whole trilogy.
I wonder what this is all about. It's like a movie series.
What's the pick is Kentucky, and I think it's a really, really good bourbon.
Oh, that's a good bourbon.
You should try. You said you wanted a bourbon?
Yeah,
try this.
That's great. Damn. Phil?
Explain, like, what does it taste like? What are the tasting notes?
I don't know how to explain this
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I don't have the vocabulary.
All right,
yeah.
Tim, you're going to have to explain
the taste. I don't have the vocabulary.
Yeah,
you just do.
But I can tell you, it's just good.
It's just good.
It's just good. Like, you like with this kind of stuff, I don't even want to talk. I want to just drink it. You know, just like, shut up.
Yeah.
Read a book.
Yeah, it's good.
There you go.
That one's nice, too.
Is it peaty?
No, I don't know how to say it.
I got a peaty, I got a sheep dung one.
Okay.
It's bourbon like scotch in that you can only get bourbon in Kentucky and you can only get scotch in Scotland, or is it like...
I think technically you're supposed to say bourbon's from Kentucky.
Like that region, right? Yeah.
But in reality, is there's bourbon in Hudson, New York, bourbon...
Yeah.
Technically if it is.
But bourbon is a US thing.
Yes. It's majority corn. Because corn is like the crop of the US, right?
Yeah, I'm probably gonna get this
Lagavulin 16.
My wife likes that. And then I'm considering this one, 1979.
Because it's your birthday one?
No, because it's my wife's.
Your wife's. Birthday. Wait, are you 78?
I'm 78.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she's 79.
Yeah, you should get that for her.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not that big of a whiskey drinker, but you can really appreciate the art. What I also find interesting is this is definitely a first rate whiskey collection, but maybe a second, third rate hotel. Like, you can't compete in the hotel business, but you know, you could definitely be one of the top, if not the top, whiskey collections in this part of Asia. we just got back from the Kuva whiskey collection, and we came back with quite a few bottles of whiskey. This is Balvenie. This is actually a quite standard one. I don't want to open it, but these are more exclusive ones that I don't know, my brother got. Hopefully you can see it through the protection. Interesting, when we were at the counter, you know, they were basically showing us this bottle, and then we had to check that it was real, and then they would box it. I think the thing that's related to this about crypto is, you know, of course, how do I know this is real, right? In the digital world, what crypto wants to solve is, I want to be able to trust whomever I'm transacting that they're actually giving me Bitcoin. Security and authenticity is absolutely foundational, right? If I can't even trust that this product you give me is real, or I can't even trust that you're saying who you say you are, there's no way any kind of communication transactions can even happen. And now, the internet, as we know it, is a very sort of dangerous, you know, insecure world, from a data centralization standpoint to, you know, hackers being able to put out fake UIs for you to punch in your name and password. I was holding this exclusive bottle, you know, they wanted me to check that it's the real label, you know, it's the real box, it's the original box, you know, and you're paying X amount of money for this. At the end of the day, the whiskey itself needs to be authenticated, right? There's still a lot of problems to be solved, but, you know, we're trying to start with something at least with some ground truth, some consensus that we can work off of. Thank you.